Welcome back to the Public Affairs Console. We're right on the front corner of the room, and we're joined by Brad Jones. He's the Partner Integration Office Deputy Manager for the Commercial Crew Program. Brad, thanks a lot for joining us today.
Appreciate you guys having us in.
Well, thanks. I always tend to start with kind of some biographical information so folks get to know, you know, who's with us. Tell us a little bit about yourself, how you got to be here at NASA, and where you're from, where you went to school.
Okay. Yeah, it's a bit of a complicated question for me, so I'll try to get through it quickly. My father was in the Air Force, so I'm an Air Force brat, and I was born in Washington, D.C. Grew up most of my life in Southern California, and then moved to Dallas, Texas, in junior high, and went through high school there. So I consider myself from Duncanville, Texas, which is just south of Dallas.
Right.
After that, I went to Texas A&M University, got a bachelor's of science in civil engineering. moved back up to Dallas and worked as a civil engineer for a few years, and decided, you know, I thought space was something that was really cool and really could change the world a little bit. And thought I would want to be a part of that. So. Applied to grad school, got into Cornell University, and went and got a systems engineering degree. From there, went back out and was looking for a job at NASA, and ended up finding something out at Stanford University on a program called Gravity Pro B, which was an unmanned scientific payload that was testing Einstein's general theory of relativity. And so I worked on that for 4 years. Done that for 4 years until. Yeah, let me try that. Worked on that for 4 years until it. Mission ops. So once we completed that mission, I was offered a job out here at NASA JSC, and had completed another degree at Stanford in aeronautics and astronautics, and so that brought me here to NASA. I jumped on that as soon as I was offered.
What year did you get here then?
I was here in 05.
Great. Well, you know, I had an opportunity to talk to Ed Mango yesterday because he was in town for some meetings, and so kind of set the stage for how the Commercial Crew Program operates, and of course you're a big part of that. And, you know, your team. In fact, he even mentioned his pit crew,
and absolutely,
which is kind of the Partner Integration Office is a big part of that. Tell us a little bit about what your office does, in terms of the overall concept of the CCP.
Sure. So the Commercial Crew Program really has two key aspects to it. There's an inside portion, and then there's an oversight portion. Partner integration is that insight function. So what insight means in this context is really we're the day-to-day boots on the ground interaction with the partners. So we have folks that are embedded in their teams. Some actually live, you know, near the partner sites and are going into their office every day. So we have NASA people working at the partner locations. We have partner managers that are leading those efforts for each of our partners, and we have seven of those. I think as Ed went over yesterday, four are funded partners, three are unfunded, but partner managers and deputies for each. And so my job as the deputy of the overall office is to help lead and coordinate the functions of all those partner managers and make sure that we're treating the partners fairly and equitably and all of those things.
So you're as the deputy, obviously there's a manager. You guys are in two different locations, and how does that interaction work within your own office?
That's right. Yes, Scott Thurston, the manager, and he's from Kennedy Space Center, and so we've got a really good symbiotic relationship, I think, with Kennedy, where for the most part Kennedy has the lead on most of Commercial Crew, and the deputy jobs go to JSC, and so you know, the distance is definitely something that's hard to overcome at times, but I think the team's done a really, really good job of that. And so having the partners spread all throughout the United States, you know, it doesn't really matter which center you're from because you're traveling around a lot anyway.
All right. Speaking of that, the project integration, you know, it's obviously not new in the space business, but, you know, there must be differences that working with these different companies, you know, like the common goal obviously is to have a new American transport to the International Space Station or to low Earth orbit. So how does that work with the different companies in terms of your role?
Right. Yeah, certainly there's differences in each company. I mean, they all have their own personality, and so it's it makes it fun, actually. It's a lot of fun to go out and interact with these guys. You've got some that are doing things more along what we would call the traditional way of an aerospace of doing business. So they go out and create a bunch of a paper design first, and then they go through a very robust process of maturing that design to a certain point in which we determine it's ready to begin development and then testing and so on and so forth until you actually get to operations. Whereas others are taking a very different approach, and both approaches are good in their own way, and so others are taking the approach of build a little, test a little. So they'll build little, they'll build components, build them up to a certain point, test them, see what happens, see what went wrong, fix that, fix their design, go back and build some more, integrate as they go along, and continue to build up the overall vehicle as they go. So it's a unique way of doing it, but.
How's the relationship? How are you being received by these companies, and how, at least from their perspective, what do you think they think about working with NASA this closely on this type of scenario, this project?
Yeah, that's a good question. I like that. We should probably ask them that question. But we do ask them, as a matter of fact, and I think it's going very well. Actually, it's taking a little bit more time with some companies than others. Others were very open right from the very beginning, invited us, opened the doors and said, "Hey, here's a desk for you," and we bring as many folks as you can because we want your help. We want your 50 years of experience. Please give it to us. So we had some that were very open from the beginning. Others were a little bit more hesitant and were letting us see small portions at a time and saying, "Hey, we want your help in this very specific area. We're doing a lot of other work, but we want your help in this specific area." As time has gone on, we've seen that change a lot, and I think all of them now are very open to to having us come in and help wherever we can.
Yeah, that's great. The Space Act agreements that the CCP works with, obviously, is kind of new, at least in the way it's structured here and with milestones and everything. But, of course, each company's working toward these milestones. Does your office have, schedules that must be met in order for these partners to stay on track? And I assume that the integration works toward that common goal.
Right. So space acts are certainly unique. They're different than a contract. I think Ed talked about it a little bit yesterday, and I'll just reiterate some of that. In a contractual world, typically what NASA does is we go out and we give them a statement of work. We tell them exactly what we want, and we tell them almost how we want them to do it, and then they come back and they go execute that for us, and that's a kind of the contract government type of role. In a Space Act world and in commercial crew, really it's their plan. We've given them some high-level goals and said, this is what in general we want to do. You guys tell us how you want to go do it. And what the milestones represent are, discrete moments in time of progress that they're making. And that's their report out to us to show we've accomplished some new task. And they range in their intent and scope from some of them are at a review level, like a PDR, a preliminary design review level. Others are, testing or drop test or something. So they have a big range in what those milestones are. So we track those milestones. Certainly that is the thrust of what our program is focused on, is making sure we're helping the partners get through those. It is their, but at the end of the day, it's their plan. So they are in charge of the schedule, making sure the milestones either happen on time or not. What we're worried about more than anything is tracking schedules to make sure that if we have some feedback that we have to give them at any point in time, that we're not holding up their schedule. What we're trying to do is keep NASA off the critical path on these and make sure that it's their schedule and their meeting.
And that's obviously the value of the integration role, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. I asked Ed this, and I tend to ask everybody, but I kind of sense excitement both on the NASA side and on the partner side. But do you sense that too?
Yeah, absolutely. One of the first things, I know when we had all of our the first round of milestones with each partner, it was amazing to talk to the team when we came back of, these guys are genuinely excited about this. I put it in the category of they're starting to get a sense for just how hard human spaceflight really is. And it's that excitement that you get only from trying to master something that's that difficult, right. And that team is, each team is motivated in their own way. And what's really, what I really find, inspiring about it is that it's not about the money. It's about doing something. It's about helping us get to a point where we're able to replace the space shuttle and close this gap of not having a capability of launching capability of launching humans. So they, you get a sense of it from each of them. They're all very excited about it, and that excitement's really contagious.
Yeah. Well, we've been visiting with Brad Jones. He's the deputy manager of the Partner Integration Office for the Commercial Crew Program. fitting setting here in the International Space Station Flight Control Room, since these companies are vying to be a transport vehicle to the International Space Station for crews. So, Brad, we appreciate you stopping by with us for a few minutes this morning. Thanks a lot.
Thanks for having me.